This is the one that really threw me. Mark 12, verse 31. The second is this: love your neighbor as yourself. There is no commandment greater than these. You notice that Jesus took two commandments, yeah? Everyone noticed that? And put them together. What I'm realizing through this is that love has to be done in relationship. Proof of that, turn to 1 John 4:12. It says, no one has ever seen God, but if we love one another, God lives in us and his love is made complete in us. Some will say, perfect in us. If you're going to be perfected in the love God wants, you've got to be good people. So if you like being Annie Jones, I'm sorry, but I'm messing up your whole worldview. I'm messing up your whole passion. Because if you like to be Annie Jacks, Christianity is going to be a problem. There's a twist though. Because who does he say to say that you have to love as yourself in the greatest commandment? Who does he attach that to? Your neighbor. All right, who's your neighbor? Just love the world.
That's what I
wanted to score. I'm so messing your head up. Because it messed my head up, because that's what I thought. Your neighbor, you see that word neighbor? If you go back to the Old Testament, Leviticus 19, 18, you shall not take vengeance, nor bear any grudge against the children of your people, but you shall love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord. Leviticus 19 is the commandments. The commandments were to the people of Israel. These were instructions for how they were to live with each other, not for how they were meant to go and live with the world. The context here is how you treat your own people, not how do I go and love the whole world. Again, look at 18. You shall not take vengeance nor bear any grudge against the children of your people. So, this can be hard to understand because we make it big, like we've got to love the world and be away with everybody else. But if we make it smaller and bring it back to our community of believers, it actually is easier to understand because that's where the example starts with us. 1 John 4. Verse 21, and we're going to move into chapter 5, just the first verse after that. This just smashed my whole paradigm, to be honest with you. I was like, what? Are you kidding me? So what I believe with all the signs being wrong? Yes, James is wrong. And actually, this is more challenging. Because if it's about your own people, this means you need to love your own folk. Because what Jesus is basically saying, what 1 John is basically saying, what the greatest commandment is basically saying is get it right in your own camp. Start there. That's what it's saying. It's not saying go and love the world, which we are told, in a very humanitarian way. Yeah. Not biblical, humanitarian, where the best thing to do is just love everybody. It's more hippified than it is biblical. What made me see? We're not here to love the world. For God so loved the world, not for James so loved the world. I can't love the world. I don't have the capacity to my household sometimes. Now I'm going to help you again with this neighbor because there's another aspect that we need to know which helps us as well. When it says love others as you love yourself, again, it helps to go back to the original language. There's a good example again in Leviticus, just a bit further on. Leviticus 19:34. The stranger who dwells among you, you shall be to you as one born among you. This is interesting as well because the stranger is the one from the outside and the neighbor is the one who's on the inside. When you read these commandments, I read through them and I realized, oh, it's becoming really obvious. But the stranger who dwells among you shall be to you as one born among you. So even when the stranger comes in, it's part of our people. We have to treat them like a neighbor, like our own. And this was back in the Old Testament. You shall love him as yourself. And here's the part. For you were strangers in the land of Egypt. I am the Lord your God. It's called them strangers. Then he said, you need to love them as yourself because you used to be strangers in Egypt. You get it? When a stranger comes in, look after them, because when you were strangers in Egypt, I looked after you. It's according to in remembrance of, that's what it means, in terms of love others as you love yourself. It's small, it's practical, it starts at home. Love's there on different levels. But at the end of the day, as an action, we all can do it, and it makes a better world. Because if we do action, if I feed you, you're hungry next time, it goes both ways. Oh yeah, you fed me, you're hungry, let me feed you too. I don't need to worry about my back, because if I treat people nice, my back's covered. Most people love doesn't go like that. Most people are like, well, what's in it for me? Even though I don't process it like that, that's how they behave. They don't get it back, you find out. That's what I was trying to go against. I'm saying the example of that is in the community of believers. That's how we should respond to each other. But First John's making it clear, start with your family. Start with those who know. Challenge is, who are his believers? Well, his believers are the ones who are acting like the Samaritan. They're doing it for the sake of Christ. He didn't do it for anything back. He couldn't do no, the man couldn't do no for it. He even paid for it, not expecting a bit back. And he even said, if you need more when I come back, let me know. Probably saw him at night there. Oh, we know. Maybe he was beat up around the road and it happened to him and he wished somebody came and helped him and no one came. Remembered himself. And he was there just as a challenge to go over. But that gives us quite a bit to think about. The choice of act, loving God, yeah, it's more than that. We have to do more. But he also wants the same with people. And it's the ones who are closest to us, and that's the heart. You need the spirit of God to love the people next to you. I'm not used to that. But it's true. It can be hard when you know their ups, their downs, their pros, their cons. It can be hard to move beyond that. Because you automatically get into a mode of judging. Because you know them. That's what it means when you say love your neighbor as you love yourself. And the way to do it is to commit to God. That's one thing I don't want us to forget, because this can sound like, oh my gosh, this is really impossible. The only way to do it effectively and keep doing it, because you are committed fully to God. Because you never want nothing back, because everything you need, you're looking for Him and to Him to get it from. And those who are on the same thing as you will make sure that you don't go without, because you are one of those, and the Bible commands us to love those who are for faith. So you're never without. But don't look to the person for it, you look to God. You might use people, but you're never without.
Guys, if you're loving it, please share and remember to subscribe right here at The Way.